Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, first we shall discuss percent change, markups and downs on commodities. In this session, we shall learn the effect of percent change, that is, percent increase or percent decrease. If I say last year 2000 people came to the city museum, and this year 3000 people came to visit city museum, we can see that there is an increase in number of people visiting the museum. Can we find by what percent there is an increase in number of people visiting the museum this year than last year? This is called percent change. And this change can be increasing or decreasing. So we can say percent change is the ratio that compares change in quantity to the original amount . So we write percent change is equal to amount of change upon original amount. When original amount increases, then percent change is called percent increase. So we can write percent increase as new amount minus original amount. Upon original amount, also when original amount decreases, then percent change is called percent decrease. So we can write percent decrease as original amount minus new amount whole divided by original amount. So we can say if amount of change is positive, then there is increase in percent, and if the amount of change is negative, then there is decrease in percent. For example, if we need to find out percent change from 10 miles to 13 miles, now here we see that the original amount increases, so the percent change is increasing. So we first find the amount of change, which is equal to new amount minus original amount. Which is equal to 13 minus 10, that is 3. As we know, percent increase is given by the formula new amount minus original amount whole divided by original amount, and here we have the amount of change, that is new amount minus original amount, as 3 upon original amount, which is equal to 10. So we have 3 by 10, which can be written as 0.3, and which can be written in the percentage form as 3 by 10 into 100%, which is equal to 30%. So we can say that there is 30% increase . Now we are going to discuss mark ups and downs. Suppose a shopkeeper got an item for $100. Now, to make profit, he increases the price and sells the item at $105. So we can say that selling price is now $105. And increase is of $5, and this increase is called markup. The increase from what the store pays to the selling price is called markup. So we can say markup is equal to markup percentage of original price and selling price is equal to original price plus markup. Suppose our store pays $90 for the skateboard and the markup is given as 20%, then what will be the selling price? As we know from above that markup percentage of original price. So here markup will be equal to 20% of 90, which is equal to 20 by 100 into 90, that is 2 into 9, which is equal to 18. So the selling price will be equal to original price plus markup. Which is equal to, the original price is given as $90 plus the markup is equal to $18. So we get $108. So the selling price of the skateboard is equal to the sum of the original price and the markup. Now we are going to discuss markdown. It is the discount given on an item and discount is a decrease in the original price of the item and we can write markdown or discount is equal to markdown percentage of original price and selling price will be equal to original price minus markdown. Now we shall study two methods of finding selling price when discount percent is given. Let us take an example. An item originally priced at $55 is marked 25% off. What is the sale price? Here, a discount of 25% is given. So first we'll find markdown. And markdown is 25% of the original price of $55. So this is equal to 25 by 100 into $55, which is equal to 55 upon 4, that is $13.75. So we got the markdown price as $13.75, and we know that sale price is equal to original price minus markdown. Here the original price is given as $55 minus markdown price, which is equal to $13.75. So here we get the value of sale price as $55 minus $13.75, that is $41.25. Thus the sale price is $41.25. Now we shall solve the same question using another method. In the above question, we are given the discount as 25%. Now we'll find percentage of original price that is today we have 100% and discount is given by 25%, so remaining is given by 100% minus 25%, which is equal to 75%. So we can say 25% discount is same as paying 75% of original price . So, sale price would be equal to 75% of original price. And 75% of original price is equal to 75 upon 100 into $55. Which is equal to 55 into 3, that is 165 by $4, which can be written as $41.25. So these are the two methods of finding selling price when discount percentage is given. Now we shall study percent error. And percent error is given by the formula that is approximate value minus exact value whole divided by exact value into 100%. If we say a person thought 70 people would turn up to the concert but in fact 80 did. Here if we have to find the percent error, we'll have the approximate value that is 70 minus exact value that is 80 upon exact value that is 80 into 100%, which is equal to 70 minus 80 is minus of 10 upon 80 into 100%, and this is equal to minus of 100 by 8, which is equal to minus of 12.5%. So we can say that person was in error by minus of 12.5%. This error is minus of 12.5% means there is decrease in what was approximated. This means that person had underestimated the value. And to avoid negative sign, we can take absolute value of percent error This completes our session. Hope you enjoyed this session.